Hey, I figured a little video on my Berthier here. I got the hand mirrored off so we can see the sight markings a little better. But I did a video on this like a long time ago, and weren't well known then. I didn't know a whole lot about it, but I guess there's a bit more information about them now. Certain big YouTubers have an interest in them, so. But this Iraqi veteran did a video recently, kind of botched a lot of the information on it, but anyway. He was going on about how it shot high and a bunch of weird stuff, but like it's basically a, I don't know, Mannlicher Berthier, or use this sort of the name a lot of people tell it, they call them. People kind of pronounce it like Berthier and all kinds of weird stuff, but those French words are dumb. But this one's Contensosa, I think is how that's pronounced. This is M-16, which was the one with the 5-shot mag. And originally I thought it might have been just that it might have had the 5-shot mag, but then it was switched back. But the mag doesn't actually match the serial number of the gun anyway, so. But apparently a lot of the ones in the first war didn't actually have the 5-shot mag yet, according to what the interweb says. But I've got like two of the reproduction little 3-round clips for it, but they work sort of okay, but not that great. But I got some cast loads made up for it. Every time I get to the range again, sometimes I might try them out. I think I got like one shooting video with it years ago. And it seems to do fairly well. Like, it seems to be fairly accurate for apparently having, like, a ridiculously oversized bore on them. Because I just thought they were, like, 3.23, but I don't think they are. They're actually, like, a lot bigger than that. But most 8mm, like, military 8mm are not 3.23 anyway. So, but you go on YouTube and mention any of this stuff, and then you get all these comments from all these morons that, oh no, it's this. It's like whatever. But so, but you can see, like a Iraqi veteran, you complain that the thing was shooting high. You're shooting at 300 yards, which is like 275 meters or something. But if you put the sight like this, it goes 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so it's 400 meters right there. So you put the handguard on, it covers up these numbers. But then there's a hole in the handguard. Kind of like Carcanos kind of do the same thing, have that thing for the sight to go into. Anyway, they fold forward like this. The earlier, like the 1915s, I don't think they had the handguard. That was sort of like one of the, I think the M16 modifications. So anyway, the sight folds forward, and you look, it's written right on the back here, it's 250 meters, so that would actually have been fairly close, actually, to 300 yards, so it would almost perfect, but quite a few people mentioned that, but then you get these, like, the same old, a couple of people that I replied back to, I don't know why I did, but they brought out the old, well, they're meant to shoot like that. I'm like, oh god, here we go again. It's like the 300-meter battle sight Mosin thing. Because you shoot their belt buckle. And, it's like, oh my god, do people still believe that stuff? Or you must be just trolling people, because nobody's that dumb, are they? Like, but yeah, this one's like a, so a Contensosa Action. It's got a MAS barrel 1917. So, the bore's actually pretty decent on it. It's pretty much all there. I think I did see a banner for this at a gun show one time, but I think it was, I can't remember if it was actually one of the shortened ones. It didn't have a scabbard with it, if I remember right. But they're, I don't know, they're not bad guns. Like, the 3-shot mag thing is kind of strange, but they're kind of like one of the uglier looking guns. Like, kind of make the Mosin look kind of good. I don't know. And they got this weird, it's like a square nail looking trigger, which I don't know what's why French do stuff. they always say the French don't copy anybody and nobody copies the French. There's probably a good reason for that. But, jeez. Still, they're accurate guns. Like, they're well put together and everything. They're just really strange, that's all. Nothing really bad about them. But the actions aren't terrible or anything. So I can knock the camera around. This one's got the thing's got the wrong screw here. This one's always been like that. It sits up. Like I'm supposed to go in flush. But I'm not really sure what the deal is with that. But that's the one that was like in it when I got it. So you gotta take the bolt head off to get it bolted. So, because a lot of people were saying, "Oh, it looks just like a Mosin." It's like, other than the locking lugs are in the different orientation, but extractor kind of looks like a Mosin, I guess, sort of similar. It has a split bridge, but a lot of guns back then had that. Really well built and everything. Like the French had a pretty good steel industry and they were fairly up there with technology and stuff. So they just made like really strange looking guns, that's all. But, it's got the weird front sight with the... Some of them they have like a blade that sticks up beyond this, but I don't know what if they added that later or something, because all the ones I've ever seen, they had this flat, big, giant flat, and then they have, like, a notch cut in it. And there's a hole in the back, which I don't know if that was for putting, for night sights or something. But the thing for the bayonet to sit on and everything. 3 million-inch barrel. I think they're 30 inches or something like that. But they're just, like, ridiculously... long. I've got like a couple of the, I got two of the Turkish Forester carbines that are built on these. I should get them out and put them together, because I got one that's like been spoilerized. The other one was pretty good shape, but I should try to get one. I think I could build one out of the two that's decent or something, but I think I had one that had like outrageous headspace or something like that, but that's another weird thing about it, like the, he was talking about how the shells, when he was firing, they're swelling up. This one, the primer's back out and everything too, but I talked about this, I think, years and years and years ago. I had a video that you take like a PPU brass that's like unfired one, and then after you fire it in any of these guns, like any of them, like it doesn't matter, LaBelle, Berthier, like they get... I don't know if you can see it or not, but they swell up like a balloon. Like they make the 303 look almost good, and where the shoulder is and stuff. You take like a you know unfired case, and this blows forward a mile. Like it's like they got the most gross oversized tolerances. And they're their big classic double shoulder. You neck it down. Like the cartridge is like. Like, I like the cartridge and everything, but it's, like, it was horribly outdated. And then people called the Mosin cartridge ridiculously fat and terrible. Like, it's not even close to being, like, it's, like, this is super ultra-modern compared to that thing. At least it's not based on a out-of-date black powder cartridge, really, I guess. But it's, you can see why they still use this, because it's actually, you know, it's sort of within the realm of reasonable. This is just, like... I don't know, it's just, you know, what the fuck, it looks like a road pylon or something that you made it into a cartridge or something. It's just goofy, but that's the French for you. That's why guns are a good way to learn what people are like and the way they think and why they do what they do. It's just like, you know, it's just... No, it's a fine round, like it shoots a bullet at a decent velocity and everything, but it's just it's hard to put it in certain actions. There's like, because with this, you got a 3-shot mag and it's still like giant, and the 5-shot one's stuck out. I suppose that, like, the Mosin sticks down and stuff, but there's inline magazines. But yeah, if you had like staggered mag, I don't know if you had a staggered one would work with this. That'd be still be like, it'd be this fucking wide. It'd be like a 4x4 or something, but anyway. Damn, it's a great card. I like the cartridge. It's like one of your first short mag, or what it kind of looked like that, is it 325 Winchester short magnum or whatever? That's kind of, maybe that's where they got to cut the rim off. And if you, like, if you took some of the taper out of this, cut this rim off, and rebated it to, you know, like the same as like a 308 or something, head diameter, because you'd have quite a little magnum. It's quite a case, really. But anyway, I figured I'd do a little video on this gun. I hadn't had it out in a while. Now, these kind of guns are so ugly that they kind of grow on you. You kind of like them just because they're like so weird looking, and it's like, people actually ran around with these. Like, that was their front line gun one time. So, anyway. Thanks for watching. We will talk to you later.